we are going to reconsider the same data set that we did in the last week, that is your OTT perception data set, and we will apply the summary measures that you studied so far. So we will begin by importing certain libraries. So the first one that we do is import statistics library. So this basically provides functions for basic statistical operations, right? Like for calculating mean, median, or mode. So I would like to refer to it as ST in future. Next is your pandas library, and we have seen that it is used for handling and analyzing data in data frames. In addition to this, we will be importing NumPy library as NP because it is more helpful for dealing with advanced statistical analysis. So due to its broader capabilities, we need it. And for basic operations, you can have the first library. But if you have to go for more advanced statistical analysis, then you need NumPy library. In addition to these libraries, we will also be importing the class counter from collections. So let me just write it first. From collections, import counter. So what it does is that this class, basically you see over here, this class allows you to count the occurrence of elements in a list, because we will be using summary measures for categorical variables also, and there we will need it. So we need to import it from the collections module, and it will perform various counting and frequency distribution operations on your data. That is why it is very much helpful for data analysis and statistical analysis. So now we are going to load the data set. So as you can recall, last time also we write read underscore CSV, and the name of the data set was OTT underscore perception underscore data dot CSV, right? So what it does over here, so basically here we are loading the data set from a CSV file into the pandas data frame, which is referred to as data. So if you want to see how your data looks like, so we want to print this data dot, so we just want the first five rows so that we can see what are the names of the variables. So yes, so you can see over here we have the serial numbers, user ID, age, gender, subscription plan, rating, time spent, device most used, number of devices, content quality, and monthly OTT bill. So it is a combination of numerical and categorical variables. So first of all, we will focus on categorical variables. So let me just define this list over here. Define categorical columns. So I use this categorical underscore columns, and here let me just write the names of all the categorical variables that we have. So you can see gender is the first one, then second one is your subscription plan. Just be careful with the spellings, because if you make a single mistake, it will start giving you an error. Subscription plan. Next is your rating. Device most used. Then you have content quality. So So let me just check if all the spellings are correct. Gender, subscription plan, rating, device most used, content quality. So these are the five categorical variables that we have. So now what we have done over here is that we have made a list that contains the names of these five columns. So here, note that it is not meant to store the actual data, but rather it just provides a convenient way to specify like which columns in your data frame should be considered as categorical. As you can recall that there are three summary measures for categorical variables. We have mode, count, and proportion. So let us try to calculate that. So calculate mode, count, and proportion. So we will initiate a for loop over here because it will iterate through each element in this list. Okay, so it will go through each item in the list one by one and assign it to this variable column for each iteration. So for call in categorical columns, we will extract these values over here. So here what we have done is we have initiated a for loop, so it will go through this list one by one, and suppose it assigns gender to this, then here what we are doing, we are trying to extract the values from this column and assign it to values. Okay, so next we can calculate the mode now. So here we will be using the statistics library, and with that we can calculate the mode function. So mode, as we know, it is the most common value in the data set. So now let us see what is the mode value and get an idea that which column it has selected. Okay, so it is, the mode is coming out to be good. So it means here in the first iteration, it has selected the content quality. Okay, so the sample size initially was 1000. So here maximum number of users have graded the content quality as good. So that is why good is coming out as the mode. So now let us see the counts. So we can also use value counts. So for this, if you can recall, we have imported counter class from the collections module. So counter, we will write, and in bracket we will write values. So here it will count the occurrence of each unique value in this categorical column. So it will count how many times excellent is coming, how many times good is coming, and likewise how many times they have marked as poor. So if you can see this, what is in value counts, so this is what you have. So excellent has been marked by 349 users, whereas good has been marked by 445 users, and poor by 99, and fair by 107. So this is why good over here is the mode. Okay, so you have got the mode, you have got the count, and now we need the proportion. So for proportion, as you know, we need the total responses also. So proportion is basically calculated by dividing each of these by the total count, right? So let us just calculate the total responses now. Length. So basically this gives the length. Okay, so it calculates the number of responses in this particular variable that we have selected. So here in this case, it is content quality. So let me just, if you want to see what is the answer to this, total responses. So it is 1000. See, you have to be very careful with the spelling, so that is why the error was coming. So now we will calculate the proportions. So let me just write proportions is equal to, so we want the proportion corresponding to each value over here, each category that is present. So we will write count, we will divide by the total responses that we have just defined. Responses for this key value pair, value count in. Counts dot items. So let me just see what is coming here. Let me just cross check. Value count total responses is defined here, and value counts, yeah. So you can see here it has calculated the proportion for each unique value. For each category, it has given you the proportion. Right now, what is happening over here? So you can see value is there, so which means basically the category that is there, right? And then it has divided the count that you got here by the total responses, that was 1000. So for each of them, it has been divided by 1000. Now, what is happening here? How it moves in this way? Because this over here, it is a for loop that iterates over these key value pair. Okay, so if you see over here, value is basically your key because these are the categories, and count is basically these value, the answers that you have over here. So here, if you see, value counts is basically acting like a is like a dictionary-like object which stores values as keys and their corresponding counts as values. Okay, so you will have the first value, then corresponding to it, you will have the count, and likewise. Okay, and when we add dot items over here, this basically retrieves that key value pair from dictionary-like objects as a sequence of tuples. And each tuple has two elements. So the first one is the key. Key over here is the value, that is the category, and the corresponding value over here, this is the proportion that you have calculated over here. Okay, so we have obtained mode, that is good. And then we have seen what are the counts for each category in that column, and we have also calculated the corresponding proportion. So let us see if I want to print this. Print. I am printing the statistics for column. So here we want this heading to come, but here if you see F statistics, we are using an F string over here. Basically, this allows you to embed expressions also within the string. So here it indicates that first it has to calculate this expression and then it has to be embedded. So for this call over here, because it is in a for loop, it will iterate, and so whatever value is there, it will automatically take that particular column and then mention it as statistics for that particular variable, that is categorical variables. Right? So this is one thing. Next, we also want the mode also. So mode can be, I want mode to appear like this. Mode is stored in mode value, mode underscore value. So we can write it in this fashion over here. Then we want counts also. So this heading counts will come, but since there are four categories over here and we need to write each of them, so we can initiate a for loop again. For value count in So here you see we are again initiating a for loop that is iterating over these key value pair one by one, right? So this is a dictionary like object and it stores all these keys and value pairs, and here we are going to retrieve those pairs as a sequence of tuples. Okay, so if we print this, we want it to have the f string also, so that it evaluates the string and then evaluates the expression and then implements it. So we want it as, so first we want the value, that is the category, to appear, and colon should be there, and then we should have the count for each of them. So what it will do is it will first evaluate the value and count over here and then print in each loop. So now we want the heading of proportions. So again we will initiate a for loop for the value, comma, proportion in proportions dot items colon print. So you will introduce the f string over here. So we want the category as well as the corresponding proportion. Proportion, you will multiply it by 100, and then we want to add a formatting. So that is why we write a colon, and then we write 0.2f, which basically means that whatever the number you get, that will be formatted with two decimal places. Proportion, and here you will put it in percentage. So let us see what is the output for this. Statistics for content quality has been obtained. If you can see, it has given for the column that you have taken over here. So it selected the column content quality. Mode was your, so here you can see statistics for content quality. Mode is good. For counts, it has given in this way, excellent, 349, and this, and for proportions you have this. Now print, this has basically been given for giving an extra line in between. So if you want, we can have an extra line after this also. So it will separate out, right? And similarly after mode also we can write it. So we are just writing it so that the output looks readable. Fine. It has calculated it. So in this, what we have written, again we have initiated a for loop, right? That iterates over this key value pair, that is here you will have the values and the proportion in this, and here it is retrieving the key value pairs from the dictionary as a sequence of tuples, and each tuple has two elements. The first one is this category over here, these are the categories, and the second one are the proportion over here. So here I have written two, up to two decimal places. You could very well change it to three. So the output will be in the same way. Let me just run it. So you see it is giving up to three decimal places. Okay. So now since I have written it in separate input statement, so it is giving me only for the content quality. So let me just write it together, this for loop. So I will just copy it from here. Mode value, then we will write for the value counts over here. Next we need the proportion, We need the total responses as well. Next, we will print all of these. Just copy it. In for loop, this indentation has to be very correct, otherwise it will not consider it in the loop and it will give you the incorrect answer. So you have called this mode counter total proportion is also defined and we have printed. So let me just run it. So you will see that it is now coming for all the five categorical variables. So now let me just remove this because it is you are unable to read it. So here let me just write it and reload it. Right, so first of all, see now when I have run it, what it is giving me, first it is giving, it has chosen the gender column. Here you can see the mode is female. So out of those 1000 users of the OTT platform, maximum number of females are there, right? So you can see the count is 346 out of 1000, and for males also it is comparatively same. Because here you can see the proportion, that is 34.6, and here you have 33.1. Next, it considered the subscription plan. So here again, you have the mode as basic. So most of the users have opted for the basic plan, probably because of the money constraint also, because premium and ultra are expensive. So you can see basic is the highest one, that is 507, and you can notice a contrast difference in the values of other plans. Next, it chose rating. So rating, most of them have given 5 as the rating. Device most used, so they have used mobile phones, they have watched the content mainly on mobile, and the content quality again as we saw earlier also. So here good comes the maximum number of time. So the users have graded it properly. So this is how you can obtain the summary measures for categorical variables.